the tenant who had been living there before we bought the place had quite a lot of animals, which she wasn't supposed to have. And I'm assuming she didn't take very good care of them, because shortly after moving in, we came to discover that the house and the yard had a flea problem. Yeah, that was wonderful to find out. So all of the projects that I was planning on doing ended up taking a back seat to dealing with this flea problem. I have spent so much money on this. Frickin' bug bombs, pesticides for the yard, yard treatment, yard spreads, we're to the point now where we don't have them in the house. That's taken care of. They are still in the yard and we're trying to get rid of them. There's not as many in the yard because we keep treating the yard. You know, it's like a constant battle. Came to the conclusion that one of their main gathering places was under the front porch, because we had a front porch that surrounded by a rock wall. So I ripped the fucking wood out, and now it's a rock wall surrounded by dirt surrounded by a rock wall. And I'm gonna do cement out there. I already started on it. It's a slow process because like there's only so much time in the day, and I still have to work a full-time job. So, little by little, I'm gonna get that taken care of, and I'll never have a flea problem out there again because fleas can't live in the cement. So, fuck those little parasitic bastards. It's just one step at a time. It's been hard on my wife. I'm trying to keep everything good, everything together. It's fucking tearing my hair out, man. What little of it I have. So yeah, that's where we're at with the house. Fucking hey. Seriously, fuck y'all. Whoever it is keeps reporting my lies. What the fuck, dude? Oh, what the fuck your problem is, man. I fucking start this shit before I start driving, and then I just talk. Fucking, I don't look at the screen. I'm fucking paying attention to the road. It is no different than fucking, you know, having a conversation with somebody sitting in the passenger seat. Actually, it's less distracting because I don't have anybody actually fucking jabber-jawing back at me. So, like, seriously, go eat a fucking AIDS-infested cock, you piece of shit. The fuck? Fucking cock-knocking faggot motherfuckers. God damn. Anywho, as I was saying, I ain't got time to be running off to the movie theater, so I probably won't watch Shang-Chi until it comes to Disney Plus. The Disney Plus shows they did were surprisingly good, you know. There is no book news. I have my first volume written. Second volume has started, but I haven't done any work on it since buying my house. I've been so busy. You know, it's hard to justify the time. I mean, it's not like the stories have a shelf life or anything. It's, you know, not a big deal, but I really did want to get it going. Professional publishing wanted like $5,000. I was like, I can't do that. Shit, I ain't got that just lying around. Maybe I'll be able to just print a couple of copies so that I have them. I don't fucking know. Behind the tent. Holy shit. Yo, that thing falls here on fucking business.
Yeah.
Again? Really? Again? shit's getting taken down because I'm driving. Who gives a shit if I'm driving? Seriously. I don't... You guys don't make any sense. You really, really don't. You think by being a pain in my ass you're gonna stop me from doing things? You're not. Listen, I was the most pain in the ass kid. Okay, short of beating the holy shit out of me, I was unpunishable. There's nothing you could do to me, nothing you could take away from me, nothing you could make me do that fucking stopped me from doing what I wanted to do. Did I care about getting my ass beat? Yes, I did. Did it stop me from doing what I wanted to do even if I was gonna get in trouble for it? No, it fucking didn't. I haven't changed all that much. Okay? I'm just better at getting away with shit. Fuck. But this is dumb shit. Like, really, it's dumb shit. I don't know. I'm gonna get a coffee now. Whatever. Looks like y'all got more 3-minute videos coming your way for your enjoyment. Because I am not gonna stop doing what I wanna do. TikTok can go suck a fat AIDS-infested cock.
Good morning. What can I get started for you?
Good morning. Could I please have a large hot coffee, light and sweet, with a turbo shot?
Sure. Anything else for you this morning?
Oh, no. Thank you.
All right. It's May 427. You can pull around.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Honestly, I'm easy to get along with. Just don't be a fucking moron. It's not that hard. I did it again. You just don't learn. Whatever.
Room, do you sleep next to it, then put your washing on in the middle of the night?
Firstly, might I suggest switching to decaf? Secondly, most houses in America have a dedicated room for washing, for the washing machine and the dryer. A lot of times people have a table in there for folding as well. You know, we got lots of space here, so we completely abuse the space. We just take it over. If there's empty space, we fill it. It's fun. But yeah, decaf, buddy. Chill. You go ahead and watch the video that I'm stitching. All I can say is, this is a real good way to get shot. I don't know what y'all think. Two words. Child abuse.